Hello and welcome to another episode of Halo Forever. Today, I am now joined by yet another PIP member, Point in Progress. Of course, you know him, you love him, he's your favorite Twitch streamer. Beard in the hair, Harv, Parmar. How are you doing, buddy?
I wish I was people's favorite streamer.
I'm doing well. You're my favorite Twitch streamer, even though all you play these days is Final Fantasy. My God.
I'm sorry. Okay, so I've been playing this game for like 7 years, dude, and it's like, finally I have more people to play with, so it's like one of those things like, sure. Oh yeah, all right, we got to do this, we got to do that, so I'm trying to get some story. It's just like, you ever play a game that you love so much that you want other people to play it as well?
Of course. Then
just, yeah, it's just one of those things. It's just really one of those things. So I'm just happy that people are actually giving it a try. That's one of the biggest things for me.
And it's a good time. Obviously, it's in the news. It's popular. It's happening. And there's a new expansion just on the horizon. So, yeah, it makes sense for everyone to jump back in, including Frank and Fiona and a bunch of other Point in Progress folks that have joined you. So that's pretty cool. But enough about Final Fantasy. Of course, we're here to talk about Halo. We are, of course, joined to do another level in Halo. We are, of course, doing Metropolis. This is actually one of my favorite levels of all time, so I'm actually very happy that you're a part of it. This has a lot of fun driving and, of course, jumping on a specific thing. So this is the last half of when we first go to Earth. So this is going to be fun. Of course, I'm sending it to normal. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to select the skull of my choice. I'm going to go ahead and just do a Grunt birthday party. And you know what? Let's do player and enemy melee strikes and part more physic damage. That just sounds fun. So I'm just going to do that. Okay. This is the best part of the show, Harv, where I hit start and we pray that it works. And we pray that it works. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the start button.
There it is. There's the countdown.
There's the countdown. Well, we'll see.
Where does it usually break?
Oh, it'll break now-ish in a second. But if you see a jump cut, then you know what happened. So,
oh, it's in.
So you're loading in. I still have a black screen. Oh, I see both of us. Oh, this is looking pretty promising. Who knows, folks? Watch, it's probably going to... I'm going to go ahead and just put all the bad energy out now. It's going to crash.
Don't do it. Yeah. Bring it back.
I'll take it back. Of course, we are playing Halo 2 or in Season 2 of Halo Forever. This is a gorgeous game, especially on PC. So very happy that we get to tackle this game together.
Yeah, I haven't played this game since it came out. Honestly, so Halo 2, like Halo 1, Halo 2, I haven't played in a long freaking time.
Gotcha.
And yeah.
No,
that's just one of those things.
When would you say is the last time that you actually played Halo? And you haven't played it on a PC, you played it on a console, I assume,
right? It's always been on console, yeah. I've never played this game on PC. So today I'm doing it for the first time on mouse and keyboard.
It's actually...
Which is going to be interesting.
Super solid. While we were setting up, you know, prepping for the show, I was doing a couple multiplayer matches. And I got to say, I'm pretty still spicy on that sniper rifle. Pretty spicy with the mouse and keyboard now, due to all the training I've gotten from other games. So
it feels weird having an Xbox Elite controller sitting right here and not using it while playing Halo.
I mean, it feels weird. I have an Xbox right next to me, and I'm not using it right now. I'm using the PC to play this with you. So this is fun. It is loading long because I believe there's a lot of resources in this specific game.
That's fine. Yeah, as long as it's still loading.
Put on my SSD, so sorry, everybody. So it's going to take a second to load. But
yeah, because it has to load us both at the same time, right?
Yeah, I believe it loads us in at the same time.
Yeah.
Which makes sense. But we will be first seeing an awesome cutscene, which features some amazing voices, such as Sergeant Johnson, who, of course, is big key character in the early parts of the series. But two actors... that I don't know. Once you hear them, I want you to guess who they are, and you tell me who you think they are.
Oh no!
So if we get there,
the music is so good.
The music is so goddamn good, dude. And then this game specifically has the guitar versions of everything.
Yeah,
I loved it when I updated the season 2 music. It's the updated guitar riff version of Halo. So I made sure to go full early 2000s Breaking Benjamin, like Hoobastank style.
Did you play the beta that came out for Halo 5?
You know what? While we're waiting, it's a good point. Yes, I did play the beta.
Or Halo Infinite, sorry.
Yeah,
Halo
so for people who are watching this, yes, the Halo Test Flight, Halo Infinite Test Flight has happened. I'm getting a setting up game. That's old PlayStation. There we go.
So yep,
that's
there we go.
There we go.
It blew right through us. 50 cal rockets didn't do a thing. Is that Michelle Rodriguez?
It is 100% Michelle Rodriguez. Yes. Damn, okay. Fast and Furious themselves. So this is like post Fast and Furious, post Blue Crush, post
oh my
Resident
God.
Evil.
Blue Crush.
Yeah. Wait.
Then listen up.
The chief is gonna jump. Say more words. I want you to say more words.
He will.
The inhuman son of a bitch, dumb enough to get between him and the prophet of regret. Pull yourself together, because you're going with it.
What about that scare?
We all run the simulations. They're
God.
Tough, but they ain't invincible.
These blur cutscenes are so good.
He'll know what to do.
Oh man.
Yes, sir, Sergeant. Thanks for the tank. He never gets me anything.
Oh, I know what the ladies like.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I love this game. All right, this is it. This is the remastered version, obviously, with all the stuff. I'm going to let you drive the tank, actually.
Oh, my game is lagging like crazy.
Yeah, I know. I'm still trying to get into it. It should be good now. Oh, boy. Here, I'm going to hit this. Can I sit side seat? No, I don't want to drive the Scorpion. I'm going to let you drive the Scorpion.
Okay, how do I
says
E to drive?
Okay. Yeah, it says E.
Oh my God, my game is lagging like crazy. I'm getting like 4 frames.
You might have to redo your settings or something. There, while you're doing their settings.
There we go. Oh, yeah. No, are we good now? No, no.
Okay, oh, yep, you're in the tank now. Okay, cool. All right, you're in the tank. Can I get on the side? Oh, I can't get on the side. That's fine, I'll take the car.
Oh my God, I don't know what is going on.
Trying to drive with the mouse.
There we go. There we go. I think we're it's like it goes well for a little bit and then it just starts like hitching a lot. But we'll keep it going. We'll keep it going.
Okay. Hold on. I'm trying to get Michelle Rodriguez to get in the back of the car. She's not doing it. Come on. Get in the back of the car.
Relax.
She just yelled at me. Relax.
Don't worry about it. Oh God.
Oh, it's lagging. Woo! Okay, I think we got it. You know, we are playing over the internet, Canadian and United States crossing together, coming together, trying
oh
to stop the covenant.
Oh, there we go.
There you go.
You know, even with the lag, I got it.
There you go. It's coming back. It's slowly creeping back into you. Oh God, I forgot how loud
this
goddamn
game is. Oh God,
my shields are down. Oh no. Oh no!
Oh my God!
The lag is so funny.
Are you experiencing it too?
Yeah, my vehicle like paused in midair while it did a flip.
Yeah,
it was awesome.
Okay, everyone, be cool.
So Harv, the first question that I pretty much ask everybody on Halo is, what is the origin story of your gamer tag?
We're talking about H. Parmar, this one.
Yeah.
We're
is this your first
one that I use?
I mean,
this one,
you,
this
you,
is my
you,
first.
Tell me,
so
yeah.
This one right here was just one of those things where it was my first initial and then my last name. And
yeah.
I'm not very creative when it comes to gamer tags, like at all. So when it came to this one, I was like, oh man, I got an Xbox Live account. I can't wait to play some online games, especially Call of Duty. It was Call of Duty that really got me into like the Xbox Live. Oh my God.
I know, right? We just freeze frames.
I'm not moving. Yeah.
There we go. Oh, okay. All right. What if can I switch to original graphics? All right, well, if you didn't already see, massive technical difficulties with Halo and the optimization of the PC version.
Oh my God, it looks so good on yours.
Doesn't it? Doesn't it look good?
Oh,
and the fact that just switch it right there. Boom. Playing through Halo 2 original graphics. Or I can switch it to the new enhanced versions, which also look real nice. I'm just going to let those guys just chill there. They can survive if they want.
Oh, yeah.
But anyways, so Harv, while I am all the pressure's on me to play this game, how have you been, man? How's life been for you?
It's been good so far. I've been getting into the groove of work, which is kind of nice. I've been working at my job for about 4 months now and streaming at the same time. I'm still trying to find a balance.
Yeah.
Where I'm just kind of like, let's find a balance between content creation and real life. Now there's a girlfriend too as well, so like there's also that
extra difficulty. Gotcha.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the time and stuff like that, right? So I feel like I gotta dedicate just more time into content creation because I've been just kind of taking days off here and there and stuff.
Yeah.
But finding that balance is tough, man. Finding that balance is tough. Because I have a really good show idea that I'm gonna be doing soon.
Mm-hmm.
I just need more time to flesh it out. That's the only thing.
No, for sure. And I feel that way, especially when you do like a day job or you do your just normal day to day stuff. You feel like your time is being taken sometimes. And I really would rather put some of those hours into something that I would be creative about, but at the end of the day, you need money to survive.
Yeah, like, it wouldn't be too bad if I was, you know, just going to, like, working at Tim Hortons or a Starbucks or something like that, right? Like, it wouldn't be that bad. Working, like, a tech job where I have to develop and, like, implement code and stuff like that, it takes a lot of your mind as well. So then you come back, and then after work, you just sit down, and you're like, okay, I gotta make some stuff now. I gotta make some stuff now.
Can you talk a little bit about what you do on a day-to-day basis when you're not streaming?
I am a software engineer, and I make iPhone applications. I work for a company called Hewlett Packard HP.
Oh, of course.
And I work on their cloud printing and Wi-Fi. Like they're pretty much their wireless printing.
Okay.
Yeah, the application that you use that connects your phone to your printer.
Gotcha. Can you hear the music on the?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. This brings back memories, man. This brings back so many memories.
Let's talk about a little bit some of those memories. So, what was your first experience of playing Halo?
My first experience of playing Halo was in grade 9, I think. I was grade 9 or 10. And we played Halo 1 with so I played it solo for a while.
Yeah.
And then I played it with a bunch of friends. And then we did some LAN parties. That was where like that core Halo began. When we got a bunch of people together and had like 4 TVs and like 4 Xboxes and getting everybody together for like a LAN party.
Hell yeah.
And just playing Halo. And just having TVs in the different, sometimes it was in different rooms, or sometimes it was just in the same living room and you just like played player versus player like that. It was so much fun. It was so much fun.
Sounds awesome.
And that went right on to Halo 2 as well.
Well, so how was Halo 2? So jumping obviously from the LAN party experience with buddies and TVs and connecting consoles to then having Xbox Live. So what was that transition for you? I mean, were you still LAN partying it up the most mostly, or did you switch over?
That's the thing. Like, I think my Xbox Live, like, online play didn't start, like, really start until Call of Duty.
Gotcha.
I feel that's really kind of really when it happened.
I was on a roll. Literally. There you go.
And so we still did LANs for, like, Halo 2 and stuff like that. It was really Call of Duty where it started to change for me when it came to this kind of stuff. I still miss LAN parties. I miss getting together just like playing with friends like on a couch, like couch co-op kind of type thing. But honestly, I miss Halo. I miss Halo a lot. But again, I haven't, like, the thing is, like, I think I missed the nostalgic part of Halo.
Of course.
Where it was like this one, 2, and 3, right? Because these are like, those are probably the 3 of my favorite games on the Xbox. But I think it's that rose. Maybe it might be rose tinted glasses. Like watching this right now, the music just brings me back.
Yeah.
It just brings me back. And I remember the multiplayer, like guns and stuff like that. It's just like the pistol with the scope on Halo 1. It's like it was so broken. That pistol was so broken. And then playing on like Hang 'em High and shit and stuff like that. And like Blood Gulch or like, you know, like those kind of places. It's just, I miss it a lot.
When you'd obviously do snipers only on Hang'em High or pistols only on Hang'em High. Yeah. Hang'em High was the level that you really just play with your friends and just like, do 1v1 me right now. Okay, cool. We're going to be playing on Hang'em High.
Yeah.
Let's see. All right, cool. We're entering this part of the level. Let's see. And then in terms of your legacy, so that was all Xbox One. What was Halo the game that got you to get an Xbox One, or did you own an Xbox? Or was it all friends?
I got Xbox One was friends.
Now, of course, I'm talking about the original, not Xbox One, of course.
Yes, yes, yes. The OG.
The OG the Xbox.
The black system, right?
The black system, unless you got the cool translucent Halo one. Mike, I see in the background.
So my my friend had the OG Xbox. I was a PlayStation person.
Gotcha.
Through and through. Me and my brother were both PlayStation people. When I went to my friend's house, he had the Xbox, he had the Halo, he had the NBA Jam, he had those kind of games, right? Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh yeah, let's go. And then that's where it kind of began for me when it came to Xbox. I ended up buying the 360.
Gotcha.
And that's where that generation, I think I like almost completely skipped on the PS3 for the most part. And I just played Xbox 360 because like, that's where multiplayer really got into the forefront in my life.
Sure.
That's when like the Modern Warfare 2, the Halo games like really got into it, right? Because Xbox Live was, I think it was very predominant in the Xbox 360 time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very huge during 360.
Let's see here. Were you always like a console gamer? Because I primarily know you as you playing a lot of PC games lately. But you were always a console gamer? Like, what's the first console game you ever had?
My first console I ever played was Nintendo. I played, I don't remember too much of Nintendo. I remember some games off of Nintendo.
Sure, sure.
Like, you know, Super Mario and, like, that kind of stuff like that. But where it really started starting was in, when I played Super Nintendo. I played so much SNES. It was crazy. The Aladdin, the Lion King game, the Super Mario games, like all of those, like there was the Mega Man games as well. Like it's just SNES just had it, you know, it just had it. Mm-hmm. And growing up, I was mostly a console person when it came to gaming. I got into PC for MMORPGs. That's really the main thing. And if I wasn't playing one of those, I'd still be playing console. And I just, like, it was maybe 5 years ago now that I legit got a computer and, like, made my own computer. So it's still recent for me. Like, when I see people's, like, Steam, like, libraries, people got, like, 3,000 games or, like, 1,000 games or 500 games. If I looked at my library right now, I have maybe 70. Maybe 70. Because I just don't. Like I'm new to this, right?
Sure,
I'm new to the whole PC landscape. Even though I've been doing it for the last 4 years, I still feel like I'm a newbie compared to like a lot of people that have been using Steam and stuff like that for a long time.
No, for sure. Yeah, I've had Steam for a while as well, and I've noticed that all I did was collect, and it wasn't until like a couple years ago when I finally got like a souped up like PC, and I'm like, oh my god, I could finally play all these games that I've been collecting because. The Humble Bundle is just something that's just so, my God, how can I describe it? It's just so nasty. You feel it, just $10, and you just get so many like different types of games and build a library up.
So growing up, my parents don't like gaming at all, right? They're very old school when it comes to like that kind of type thing.
Ah, I see.
But when it ever came into gaming, they were always like, "No, you already have games. Why do you need more games?" Like gaming is gonna ruin you and stuff like that, right? Mm-hmm. But growing up, it was a lot. My brother is the big influence why I got into gaming, and when I was growing up, we had a 486 computer, so not even a Pentium 1. It was a 486.
Gotcha.
That's where I played, like you know, Doom and like Wolfenstein, like the old Wolfenstein, the old Doom and stuff like that, right? And Duke Nukem when it was like a thing way, way back, you know. And when we got to like. The Pentium 1 and the Pentium 2, that's when I really started getting into MMOs and stuff like that. And my parents were never on the board of like, just, you know, we need to get a new computer. Like, no, why do you need a new computer? You have a computer sitting there.
Yeah.
It does everything that you wanted. So, and then it was just like that with consoles as well. And my brother, who had like a well-paying job, he started buying the consoles, and that's how I got into all of the stuff that I am into now as well. So.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Wow, you took so many flips.
I'm still alive.
So many flips.
Oh God, I don't have nothing to do anything against these tanks now.
SMG.
Jesus, why did I even bother? I thought if I just ran to this door, it was just gonna open up. I thought I had the foresight there, but nope. Now I'm just pinned to this little area.
You got nades?
I got. Hold on, 1 second. You're right. Oh, all
right. Okay, well, now I just ran right through.
That's fine. I needed that refresher. I got to convince this guy to get in my vehicle. Or I got to steal one of those ghosts.
I guess nobody's...
Stop moving. All right. So I find that funny how both it's your family's fault for both A, your love of games, and also for why you should not be playing them.
Yeah, it's a tug of war that I've been having for a long time. I think it was like until, honestly, it was probably when I hit like 27.
Mm.
It's when I got on my own and I started making money, and I started like making, like, you know, I had disposable income and all that kind of stuff, and I got into gaming. It really dawned on me. It's like, this is kind of what I love to do. Mm. Right? I kind of love to do this. And then when I figured out whether it was content creation was involved, I was like, oh my God, I want to do this. Like, this would be so much fun to do.
Yeah, it's so funny because, if I'm not mistaken, I got to meet you a couple years ago. We met IRL for the first time, actually, at Kind of Funny Life 3. We've been hanging out with Mike Ruiz, Amber, and the guys. And you were not streaming at that time, right? You were...
No. No, I was... I wasn't streaming at all at that time. I was just playing games. I don't know what I was doing at that time. It's just one of those things, like, because I've been watching Kind of Funny for a long time, mm-hmm. and, you know, meeting up with a lot of people was awesome and stuff like that. I think it was just one of the, I just hadn't taken the plunge yet to do it.
Gotcha.
That was the biggest thing. I just hadn't taken the plunge yet.
What was it that made you like, you know what, today's the day, I'm going to go buy a webcam, set up, OBS, learn OBS, learn all these systems, these programs, these websites. Like, it's funny, in the small period of time that we've been doing it live, you know, for a point in progress, you've taught me already so much. Like, what took the dedication, the time to get all that going?
So the first things first, I love learning theme things. That is one thing that I really enjoy doing. And this was just another thing that I could learn and like, just have like a thing under my belt where it's
got
like
you.
I see something that I don't understand. I'm like, how do I understand this? What do I need to look at to understand how to get this to work? Also, how is this going to help me later on? So I like to do that kind of stuff. And I don't remember like what, like it was mostly. So I've told this story on my stream, so I'm gonna say it here as well.
Yeah.
So I watch a guy named Tim the Tatman. He's a pretty big streamer. I don't know if you ever heard of him.
Oh yeah, I hear he sucks at Fall Guys.
Yeah. He sucks so bad that he got like 300,000 to 400,000 people watching him.
Yes.
Yeah. Crazy.
Oh man, this part. Look at that thing. Hold on.
Oh, that thing is. What is it? I was gonna say, how does it look on the old graphics?
That's hilarious.
Oh man, it looks so much better than the new graphics. It looks so much better.
I always feel this funny when they remaster games and I'm like, yeah, this is how I remember it. And it's like, no, this is how you remembered it. You know, I was like, this is rose-tinted glasses. That's what this is.
That's exactly what I'm talking about, right? They got the rose-tinted glasses and be like, man, I remember this game being this good. And you're just like, maybe not. Oh my God. Look at like, the scale of that.
It's
so good.
Yes. Oh. And I knew, like, the turn, look at the exact moment.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's that turn.
Love it.
So I watched Tim the Tap Man, and so streaming got me through a lot of things, like, personally, of just, like, hardships and stuff like that, mm-hmm. like anxiety, depression, like, that kind of type thing. And there was a moment where it was, like, somebody donated to him saying, like, you know, you've gotten me through all this stuff, so I want to thank you, and, like, you got me through like the hard times of like somebody dying in my family or something like happened in his life, like girlfriend, boyfriend, like that kind of type thing. And I wanted to be somebody that, I wanted to be that for other people, you know? That was one of the main reasons why I wanted to do it, because I wanted to help other people try to, you know, get away from whatever they're doing.
Yeah.
And like, you take like a couple hours out of their day and just chill and just try to be as entertaining as possible. I am the most introverted person that you like. I'm very introverted, very introverted. So like, this has all been a learning experience for me and a very eye-opening experience, I guess one would call it. Because I still am introverted.
Sure.
And I'm breaking that barrier has always been difficult for me. God, that music is so good.
I know, you were talking about something serious and I'm just like,
oh, I know.
Oh my God, this is the part. Again,
like,
yeah.
There's something in games when that music drops and you're just like, let's fucking go.
Let's fucking go.
All right, I can swear, right?
Yeah, we can swear. We murdering aliens. It's fine.
Yeah, I was just like, let's fucking go, dude. It just gets me so hyped.
Yeah. Fuck it. Let's go.
There you go.
Oh, reload.
What is one of your favorite aspects of Halo?
Honestly, I think it is the world that exists with it. But how? Oh God damn it!
I had a feeling that was gonna happen there for a second.
Yeah, there's just something about the world, and I brought this up mainly during season one of Halo Forever. But basically, what my love for Halo comes from, the fact that a lot of the inspiration is from classic movies. So this is heavily inspired by James Cameron films and all those old war films. And there's just something about the style, like the way that the Covenants look exactly like the monsters from the Abyss. Like the Abyss, there's the end scene with the Abyss where you see the ship, and the ship is literally just from the Covenant. Like it's the same design and everything. And the way that James Cameron tells a lot of stories tends to be similar to this. It's, you know, it's the rising action of these like badasses that, you know, go in and kick ass. Like if you're, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger in the Terminator, or if you're, you know, Ellen Ripley, like that, you are Master Chief, you know, you are that, you know, that figurehead. So I think that's definitely what helps. The music is massively a key part of it. The music by Marty O'Donnell kicked ass, and this has Bon Oliver and other mixes and stuff like that. Like they come together so inceptly when it comes to both visuals, the sound, the action, the characters, the designs. It all just comes so beautiful, and this is why Halo's has always been like one of my favorite franchises, not because it's a shooter, but for a story too. And I know that like people like Frank or people that are like heavily into lore, to me it was never about the lore, it's about the experience of being in the game. So playing the games, like I could read the books and I can, you know, maybe watch that television show that's coming on HBO, Showtime, but, or Paramount, actually, they moved it over to Paramount. But I think playing the game and being in control, I think that's what's always made Halo special.
So I agree with you when it comes to like just the story and not like the lore part. Like this is what I love about, like, so I want to take The Last of Us, for example.
Yeah.
Right. I want to experience the story. The lore is whatever to me.
Sure.
Right. It is what it is. It's a post-apocalyptic, a fungus kind of went around and, like, killed everybody. Like, that happened. It is what it is. But it's a story of what happens in that particular game is what I really care about. And I think Halo is the same way for me.
Yes.
Like, I don't really care how, like, you know, the Halos were started or any of that kind of stuff. I want to see Master Chief's story and where it takes them.
Exactly. The two core components of the entire Halo series for me is just Master Chief and Cortana. Like, that's the story that I care about and what makes me want to, you know, see what their next adventure is. So when you get to this game and then you leave Cortana on the ship and then... Hold on, sorry. Ooh. Hold on.
There you go.
And then, she then, like, in the next game, all of a sudden is, like, getting really rampant and, like, you don't know what's going on with her.
Yeah.
I love how they carry that over, especially onto... Halo 4. Halo 4, I think, is actually like one of the underrated Halo games. I think a lot of it's because I think the actual character models and new things they introduce is not the greatest, but the story between Cortana and Master Chief is actually really very reminiscent in my heart. It makes me cry when I think about it.
Yeah. That kind of reminds me of...
I can do cutscene switches too? That's awesome.
It kind of reminds me of Final Fantasy 15 a lot. Because Final Fantasy 15, the story, the entire story is not great. Like, it is whatever.
Yeah.
But it's like the friendship of the five characters is what really stands out in that game.
Yes.
And that kind of what reminds me of Cortana and Master Chief in this game. Right? That is like a main component of the game. If that component doesn't exist, these games are not as good as what they're supposed to be. Like, they do not hold what they are.
No, they just become every other shooter. You know, like the shooters that don't work. And I will say, as a shooter, it is still fantastic. Like, it's still by far one of my favorite games to play. You know, I was just playing multiplayer before we did this, and it still runs smooth in my opinion. Like, I still love the way that Halo 1 moves. Now, you have to get accustomed to it, because they have changed it every game. But I still think that as action games, like, they're still some of the best games. Like, I can play a Call of Duty game, and I can tell you which is a good Call of Duty, and I can tell you which is a bad one.
Yeah.
You know? I can definitely tell you. But I can tell you which one's a Bungie, and I can tell you which one's a 343 game.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Because, they're very distinct on how they play.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, 100%.
So I'm going to go ahead and see if I can pause this and then just talk to you for just a few more minutes and then pretty much wrap up. Don't worry. This game will take forever to load, so it's all right. In terms of where you see yourself growing in the next, you know, even I'll say year or two or so, because your base has started from, you know, just you jumping on stream with nobody watching to now at least over 20 to 50 I've seen sometimes show up in your group. Like, how has that rise been for you? Like, seeing those numbers steadily grow.
Steadily is a mild thing to say, because it's I've been doing this for about 4 years now.
Yeah.
Almost 4 years. And I would say, like, really getting into the nitty gritty of it for two. Mm-hmm. Right. One thing that I've learned through all of it is, like, there are no shortcuts when it comes to this. If you aren't putting in the time, nobody's going to put in the time to watch your content. That's the biggest thing, right? And what I've seen throughout this whole journey is, like, you got to put your all into it. You can't half-ass this shit. You cannot half-ass this shit. And I want to strike a balance where, like, I can make content for a living and not worry about, how am I going to pay the next bill? Right? How am I gonna get the next grocery list, or, like, what am I gonna do for groceries and stuff like that? Right? Because I was unemployed for a long time. I saved a lot, but, like, there was also that thing in the back of my mind. It's like, okay, well, I can't live like this forever. Like, this is just not gonna happen.
Yeah.
But I made the best content during that time because I had all the time to pour into that particular thing. So I made the best content in there. And my steady growth has been awesome. It's been great. It's a fine line between a steady growth and keeping everybody there, because I say this as a variety streamer, it is hard as a variety streamer to keep a steady growth going. I think you could ask anybody out there that does, especially in a smaller streamer aspect of when you switch from one game to another, it is hard to keep that growth going. It is very hard. So I'm just hoping to get to a point where people, even if I can be a variety streamer, or I'll just be a Final Fantasy 14 full-time streamer at this point.
Apparently.
Yeah. And I'm hoping that people would stay at, you know, for me and not what the game I'm playing. But again, that is all. I can't fault anybody for taking, you know, the ladder of being like, whatever, like, you know, they're there for that particular game. Stop playing that game. They're not going to be there anymore. Kind of happens.
No, for sure. But I definitely see there's definitely quite a bit of loyalty in your chat, specifically through a lot of names that I see repeatedly coming back over and over again, and people that follow you. They even follow you to, you know, Point in Progress, which is something I want to talk about really briefly, because it is something that we are a part of, both me and you. We've pretty much transitioned to live, which I think was a big part of the E3 stuff that we decided to do, and your expertise and allow and teaching us new things. Like I learned so many new things with the stream elements that I think are absolutely incredible that I wish I had prior knowledge. But how's been the point in progress experience been for you to be just part of a panel, be part of a group of people, as to not having to do it all by yourself?
Oh, it's been, oh my God. Okay, so I want to go back a little bit.
Sure.
With this, because I've been wanting to join, like, so I've been wanting to get it through with, like, get in with a group to, like, talk about content, talk about games, talk about movies, talk about whatever kind of nerd culture we could, like, you know how people say nerd fandom or nerd culture.
Of course.
That we want to talk about. Like, I've been wanting to do that for a while, and I remember when you guys were talking about it amongst yourselves, like, I think it was you, Fee, Frank, and Sly talking about it. Mm-hmm. And it was one of those things where when I was hanging out with you guys, I just wished, like, I just, there's a part of me just wish I was part of it. Because I've been wanting to do that stuff for so long. And having that now has just been, I look forward to every Friday. I look forward to us sitting down and talking about the news, or us, like, planning stuff that is, like, E3 was, it was hectic, it was crazy, but it was so much fun.
It was a lot of fun.
It was so much fun.
The good and watching. The bad panels.
Yeah, good and the bad panels. If they're bad panels, we just talk shit about them. And
the whole time. Panels,
the whole time. It doesn't matter what was on the screen the entire time. We just talk shit.
Yeah.
But, like, it has helped me immensely as a person. It's helped me as a person that makes content, and it's helped me to delegate things that that I'm like, you know what, I can't do it this week. Can somebody else take care of it? Or I'll be like, you know what, I'll take care of this. I'll take care of it this week, and let's get this show on the road, kind of type thing. And then just thinking of more creative ideas of, like, what to do, because there's a couple things in the pipeline that I'm planning to do for Point in Progress that I can't wait to, like, just kind of, because, like, when I want to tell everybody in Point in Progress, I just want to be like, this is the plan, or like, this is the idea, and that's it. I want to have a full fledged plan before I come at it. Be like, this is what I want to do, kind of type thing, right? So. And I just having you guys as the most open-minded people has really kind of made the experience probably the best thing I could think of, honestly, when it comes to, like, a panel and just us hanging out all the time. Because, honestly, we hang out all the time.
Yeah, well, definitely now, especially with all the goddamn Final Fantasy. It's been killing it. What happened to Among Us? Remember we used to play, that a lot.
But that was the kernel, though, right?
That was the kernel.
Among Us was the kernel. That's where I met Frank. That's where I met. I got to know Fee. That's where I met Sly.
Yeah.
And obviously, I've known you for a while, but, like, you know, it's the game that kind of, it was like the catalyst, I feel.
No, 100%. I'll thank Among Us for definitely partially the creation of Point in Progress, for me reconnecting with Fee. I know Fee was someone that was, like, part of this kind of funny community, and they are friends with, like, everybody, and they're super awesome. And getting a chance to be in her, her Discord server and inviting me to play games, and me bringing Frank a part of it, really changed my whole year. So definitely for the better. And
I feel like Frank took a good, like, 180 when it comes to, like, this kind of stuff too, because, like, I remember talking to him about it and saying, like, he was never, like, wanted to be a part of that kind of type thing, and then just meeting new people and meeting us specifically just kind of changed his whole perspective on everything too.
Yeah, and honestly, being surrounded and, you know, not being isolated in the time that we had, which, you know, we kind of came forth because of the pandemic.
I was gonna say maybe it was, like, one of those things where it was the best for us because the pandemic happened, because it put us into that gear of, like, doing it all together, right?
Yeah, exactly. And not feeling,
and
like,
it's,
you have
easier
to do it
than
alone.
Ever. And it's easier than ever to do now with the tools that we have. Some people use Zoom, we use Discord. And there's so much out there that is possible to have a show from different places.
Yeah, three time zones, two countries, five friends.
Yeah,
progress is made. Oh, the wrong podcast. Well, we definitely made some progress here on Halo Forever. Of course, we've made it through yet another level. We are now moving on to the next level next week, the Arbiter, which I'm very excited because I do love me some Keith David. And I think the Arbiter is a wonderful character, despite how we used to think about it. In comparison to him and Locke, the Arbiter is way better.
Yeah, 100%.
I remember people were like, well, we're playing as the aliens. This is weird. I'm like, trust me. You don't have no idea what's coming to you.
Yeah, Locke was just a huge setback, in my opinion.
Oh, I can't wait till you play Halo 5 on this show. I just can't wait. Of course, Harv, where can we find you on the net?
You can find me at Beard and the Hair, pretty much everywhere except YouTube, which is Beard and the Hair Gaming. You can find me on Point in Progress. Every Friday, we record a podcast over there. And there's going to be some more content coming out of there as well. And I got a new show that I'm going to be starting on my own YouTube channel, which I'm very, very excited about. I'm not the greatest writer, so this is going to be a learning process for me.
Sure.
Because I got to write jokes and stuff, and I'm not the greatest at writing jokes.
You better hope you're funny.
I feel like I'm funny enough, but at the same time, I'm just like, do I know people that can write really good jokes?
I mean, sure. I punch up some stuff. That'd be funny.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's something that people have already watched kind of on like mainstream television that I'm trying to bring to YouTube and to gaming stuff. So I'm excited.
That's awesome. Well, obviously you can find Harv at Point in Progress. You can also find me there at Point in Progress, where I also give away my opinions about the latest news and some spicy takes that we have throughout the show. We are continuing here at youtube.com/thatMarioRivera, where every week we are having a new episode of Halo Forever. We're currently going through Halo 2 as we do. So many fun times we've had today, including all the wonderful bugs. So
I wish I could have played this with you. I really do.
I know. At least and you get to watch.
Yeah. I got to experience it again.
Yeah. But like, see what it looks like. Yeah.
Man, it's very demoralizing when like, I'm so excited for Halo Infinite, like very, very excited for Halo Infinite. Yeah. And I want to play through all the Halo games, but knowing that PC version is having some problems on my computer for some reason.
I know.
But I'm gonna try to rectify that at some point.
See if you can figure that out. Keep it installed. Keep it and see if we can get that fixed. Because I would love to play some multiplayer games with you guys in the future, especially in Halo 1, 2, and 3, and all the rest of the games. But of course, you can find Halo Forever on that Mario Rivera at youtube.com/thatMarioRivera. You can find the audio version on all major platforms. So if you have Apple Podcasts or Spotify, it is there. All of season 1 is there. All of season 2 will be there as well. And you can find me normally on Twitter at thatMarioRivera, but I'm still blocked. Still trying to get that figured out. But honestly, until next time, let's finish this fight.